Hey there, this is a follow-along lesson from my course on Adobe Muse, where you can learn web design by creating a responsive website in Adobe Muse. Support files included. Check out the link in the description for more information. Thanks. In this lesson, you'll learn about the importance and usefulness of master pages. When we're designing web pages and adding content such as photos, text, illustrations, or videos, those elements are often just on that specific page you're putting them on. For example, the directions page to a business might be the only page that has a map on it, and a biography page might be the only page that has information on a company's founders. But some content should be on all the pages of a website, such as a consistent navigation at the top, a footer at the bottom with contact information or social media links, or a specific background color across the site. And we want to be able to change that content without having to change it on all the pages one at a time, whether the website has 5 or 500 pages. That's why we have master pages. If you're familiar with Adobe InDesign, the concept of master pages should be familiar to you. If you're not familiar with it, no worries. We'll go over how to use them effectively in Muse so that we have consistent design elements and functionality across the website. So let's get started adding common elements. Double click on the master page called A Master down here. That brings up the master page in design mode. The guides will not show up on the website. They're just guides for us to go by as we design. These vertical guides are from the columns, while the horizontal guides are for the header and the footer areas, and also to adjust margins. The vertical space available is based on the initial minimum height that we set earlier. We can click and drag the inside arrow here to add more space between the bottom of the browser and the bottom of the page, which is controlled by this arrow. For this project, I want the footer to be flush with the bottom of the browser window, though, so let's move that back up. We can also adjust the height of the header and footer and add some spacing above the header if needed. Click and drag the top arrow in order to add some spacing between the top of the page and the top of the browser. This really depends on your project, as some navigations can be flush with the top of the browser, while others will not. For this example, let's set this to 10 pixels for a little bit of breathing room above the header and the page. As I click and drag, it indicates the distance between the top of the page and the top of the browser here. Next, let's click and drag this arrow to 75 pixels, so it's 75 pixels below the top of the page, which is 10 pixels from the top of the browser. So really we have 85 pixels of space up here to work with, including the extra spacing of 10 pixels for some breathing room. Let's set the top of the footer to 450 pixels, since that will put it at 50 pixels above the bottom of the page here, since our initial minimum height is set to 500 pixels. Next, let's add some content up at the top in order to delineate the header from the rest of the page. One option would be to add a line here in between the header and the rest of the page. If we were coding this, we could just add a horizontal line in the code, but in Muse we can add a rectangle and then just have one side of it have a line. Click on the rectangle tool on the tools panel, and then let's click and drag across the top here so that the bottom of the rectangle is along the bottom of the header area. Click up on stroke up at the top and set it to a color. For this example, I'm just going to set it to black. This controls the thickness of the stroke or border, and I'll keep it set to 1. We could curve the corners by adding a corner radius or a few of them here, but I'm not going to add that in this example. We could also add effects like a shadow, bevel, or glow, but those often look unprofessional, but can be sometimes relevant or professional. It depends on the client branding and how the effect is done. We can also adjust the opacity of a selected shape to make it less opaque and more transparent if we want here. Back over here on stroke, let's click on the word stroke. Let's make sure the stroke is aligned to the inside of the shape for this example, and then also let's click this so these are not all linked to be the same. Then make the stroke weight for the top, left, and right set to 0. We'll have a line at the bottom. We can preview what this looks like by going to Preview at the top. Notice that the line doesn't go all the way across. That's because I intentionally didn't set the rectangle to go to 100% width earlier, just to show what it does. This is more relevant to fixed width layout websites, although some shapes and photos can be a fixed width even in fluid width websites. But for this example, we want the link to go all the way across regardless of how large our browser window is. So with the selection tool selected, click and drag the shape so that it snaps to the edge and says 100% for W or width. Make sure that you select the shape and not the bar that sets the breakpoints, which we'll go over later. There we go. Now go to Preview and let's see the difference. That's how we add a line that goes all the way across the window, regardless of how large or small the browser window is. For this project, I don't want a line though, but I wanted to show you how to easily add one. I'm going to add a rectangle that has a fill. Since this is for a client that gives hot air balloon rides, we want the colors to be bright and sunny. I'll delete the shape we just designed for the line, and I'm going to create a rectangle at the top for the background of the header. And I'm going to set the fill to somewhat light blue, sort of like the sky, but still a strong blue. I'm going to use the 6-digit or hexadecimal code 29ABE2, and then enter. You can use that or select a different color. Now let's add a background color to the footer area by drawing another rectangle over that area. With the stroke set to none for this one as well, let's change the fill to a color that is not super bright that could easily distract from the content on the page, such as the photos that we'll eventually place here. I'm going to set it to C69C6D, which is a more muted but still relevant color. We could make it more of an orange color if we wanted to create a complementary color scheme with the blue, but we'll go over color themes later and how to set that up. The cool thing is we'll be able to adjust this later if we need to, and it will reflect across the pages since this is on a master page. Make sure the edge goes to 100% as you draw those rectangles. If we need to adjust the size after we initially draw it, we can use the selection tool and click and drag the top side or corners or left or right side. Now we have the basics of the master page set up. The content reflects across the entire website. Any changes made to the master page will reflect across the pages. Now, let's say we wanted certain pages to have a slightly different color at the top or a different size footer or whatnot. We can add a new master page down here. Just add a page by clicking on the plus sign. By default, it's called Be Master. I'm going to quickly just add some content to it. For this example, how about a circle? And we'll add some color. And notice that none of the pages have this content. That's because they are all associated with a master, which is indicated below each page. To change that, just right click on the PC or control click on the Mac and go to Masters and then Be Master. Now this specific page has the content from the new master page. We need just one master page for this project though, so I'm going to set that back to A Master and delete B Master page. Now be sure to save your work, preferably with a new name so we have a backup file, or at least save another instance of it somewhere. Thanks, and I'll see you in the next lesson. Hey there, this is a follow-along lesson from my course on Adobe Muse, where you can learn web design by creating a responsive website in Adobe Muse. Support files included. Check out the link in the description for more information. Thanks.